before we start this video is dedicated to my good friend Zero to Pass. I hope you're doing well, Zero. Please leave me in a comment if you are watching this video and what you feel about this list. I'm going to try my best. I'm definitely not the smartest Shiranui player, and frankly, neither are most of you. Hey, what's going on, guys? I'm Season 4 here. Today, I am back to cover Shiranui after a whole month of delay. I wanted to delay it, to be honest, because I wanted to see the WGPs, plus I had a lot of personal issues. Today, I finally captured one of my own Shiranui players, and today we have Nami.
Hey, what's up, guys? Nami here. I'm Amish's local Shiranui player.
So, before he puts himself on ceremony, there are a lot of Shiranui players in the wild. You don't need to catch them, just put out some food in your basement. You can kind of see one appear later on in the night. Today, we're going to be talking about Shiranui, one of the latest from the Strike Deckset series, which literally is just a beginner-friendly product, an intermediate product, and a competitive product, all in one go. It's frightening how good this set is. Frankly, it has caused a lot of panic. But they did nerf Oboro, I can see you. So I'm glad, but we don't know whether they will hit this in a ban list or not. Judging by the fact that I'm releasing this video right before the ban list, that tells you one thing. I don't think so. So today, let's go through this deck, how it works, how you can stop it, and what are the few ways you don't need to spend 6,000 yen to bring him to his knees. So let's break it down real quick. We're going to go through it slightly differently due to the nature of the Gzone. So we'll start off still with the right deck first. Okay, so let me just sort it all out. Okay, so moving on to the right deck.
Okay, starting from the right deck, we have Madoi, Seizui, Genkai, and Shiranui Oboro, your boss unit. Now, you might be noticing that I am not running Shoujo Doji, the Grade 2. I have a good reason for that. That's mainly to make this deck a bit more budget due to certain reasons. Because Shoujo Doji, if you're playing the Hyper Stealth variant, it gets very pricey.
Not only that, Shoujo Doji, while gives you extra aggression, it does leave you open for a problem. That is that you don't actually get to use Genkai skill because you need a way to force resurrect without betting on Oboro. So I'll just say this skill first. When placed on the Vanguard Circle, the top 5 cards in your deck, choose up to 2 stealth, call 1 to the rearguard circle and bind 1. So you can thin 1 and you also get a free plus 1 rearguard. And it can be any rearguard you wish. So it can even be if you have the original Grade 3 Shiranui, it's also in this deck, or you can just pull out Furai, you can pull out a
Zankei,
or you can pull out this guy. Like, you can pull anything from the deck, so it's really strong. But the downside of playing Shoujo Doji as a Grade 2 is that you can be denied. We will go through that in a bit.
Okay, just for you to have an easier understanding on what the deck does, let me go through the abilities of each of the cards in the right deck. So, going through Madoi is your normal starter when rode upon. If you go second, you get to draw one. Typical D starter skill, nothing too special. But because it's a Shiranui deck, just for the good flavor, we are playing Madoi.
No, it's because you need it for this skill too.
It's just when placed.
It needs to be placed on top of Madoi.
Oh, well, okay. Speaking of, the Grade 1, its ability is when placed on Madoi, you get to open up your Shiranui crest, which if you are unsure what it does...
We'll go through it right after this, but the other part of the skill is that it draws. So you get a plus 1 draw?
Yes, you get to draw 1 from revealing the crest.
Yep, that's it.
Okay, afterwards, it's Genkai. So Genkai's effect, Self-Dragon Genkai, its effect is when rode upon... Okay, so on place, it doesn't really have its own skill.
Yeah, it doesn't do anything.
Yeah, so when rode upon, you can call this card from your soul to your rearguard circle, then soul charge 1. After which, you can choose up to 1 unit card from your opponent's drop zone and call it to the rearguard circle. Yep. That rearguard will stay. It will not retire at the end of the turn. So that's why sometimes you have to be a bit more cognizant on what you are going to call out from your opponent's drop zone. Because if you give them an important combo piece, it gets very troublesome for you. So you have to be wary on what you are calling. The soul charge is also very important because later on you'll see that there's a lot of skills in our deck that requires soul. Okay? Its other ability is on rearguard circle, when your dominated unit attacks, you may counterblast 1 and give that unit plus 10,000 power until end of that battle. Then, Genkai gains the ability to boost until the end of turn.
Yeah. So they took inspiration from both G and V.
Yes, because the V Genkai it gives any unit boost,
yes.
But the D Genkai isn't as good. And giving your opponent's dominated unit more power makes it harder to guard, which
yeah.
can force out more cards, and on lethal turns, it can be very devastating.
But just be careful, because you need to give it 10k at the end of battle, so just be aware in case you want to swing backwards on it with Mukuro, but that's a small implication.
Right. It's until end of battle, so the power.
Oh yeah, doesn't matter because it ends one battle, it starts another.
Yes.
So it's still fine.
Okay, then we have our next main boss, Demon Stealth Dragon Shiranui Oboro.
It's the same card from 2016.
Yes.
It's definitely the same card.
So if you're unsure on what this skill is, you've never seen it before, let me go through it real quick for you. All right. So the first ability is at the beginning of your right phase. You can choose one card from your opponent's drop zone, and they choose to call it to your opponent's rearguard circle. At the end of the turn, that unit is retired.
Yep.
Then, when this unit is thrown upon, you can choose one of your opponent's rearguard, stand it, and dominate it, and it gets plus 4k, and conduct the battle with it. You can choose to attack any unit on your opponent's side of the field. You can choose to use that unit to attack your opponent's vanguard, your opponent's rearguard. So you can either use it as a tool to pressure damage or a tool to control the board. Normally, what I do is whatever unit I call from the drop zone, I use that as something to swing at the rears with if my opponent has too full of a board. It's good field control. It's a completely free skill, which makes Oboro a very strong strider. Okay, next, we'll go through the crest. So the crest is given by our great one. It has several abilities. I'll go through each of them one by one. Firstly, the crest allows you to stride.
But you can only ride great trees with Demon, Stealth Dragon in the name. So this only counts for two cards, which is Demon, Stealth Dragon, Shiranui Oboro, and Demon, Stealth Dragon, Shiranui
Zanki.
Blazing Stealth Dragon.
Blazing Demon,
Demon Stealth Dragon, Shiranui Zanki. Thank you.
Okay.
But Zanki's not here, so you have to wait to 2028.
Yes. Then, second effect is all of your Demon Stealth Dragon Shiranui gets a 13k base because all of them currently have 11k base because they are from their original print back from 2016. The third continuous effect is for every face up card in your G zone, your front row gets plus 10k. Your front row, because of domination mechanics, you need to understand that even if you dominate your opponent's front row rearguard, it's still considered part of your opponent's front row. So the crest does not give power there. So only your own front row gets the 5k power.
Mm-hmm.
And then finally, the last effect is continuous. Any unit that was called that was placed by your Vanguard's effect on your opponent's side of the field,
or is dominated,
lose all of their continuous and auto effects until the end of the turn,
yes.
And they also gain plus 5k.
Yes.
All right. So this makes it so that this crest gives very special interactions to certain cards. Let's say if you dominate Greedon as a Vanguard, you can nullify their continuous effect to lose at 7 damage. Or if you dominate one of your opponent's cards that say they can intercept from the back row because of
yeah.
a continuous effect, you can
yeah.
completely nullify that. So you can use this as a very special control option. But if your opponent has any resist effects, you are still unable to target that card. So be very careful with that.
In addition, if your opponent has also played the Regalis piece for Climbing Angel Ladder, it straight up just gives your whole board the protection. So it makes Shiranui completely limbic, then he can't do anything for a turn, he just loses the game outright. But sorry about that. See, it makes even my camera disabled. Alright, so I think we've done enough talking about the basics of Shiranui and what it does. Let's go into a bit more of an intermediate course. We'll talk about the strikes. Okay, so we play 4 copies of Malcolm Tembu and then 4 copies of Shiranui Mukuro. So they're quite similar to how they used to be back in G, but I will still go through it very quickly. We're doing the G-Zone first because all of your skills are triggered by the G-Zone. What I specifically mean is targeting after domination. Every other card in this deck cannot dominate. Besides Oboro and besides your strikes, there is no other source of domination. So the rest of this deck is kind of like a toolbox where you play based on the different effects that you've either gained through domination or you want to play alongside domination. But all of your Shihai effects come from the center column. With that out of the way, I'm going to go through it really quickly. Your basic strike is obviously going to be Mr. Margen Tembu, drawn by Daisuke Izuka. Look at that art. It's beautiful, isn't it?
Totally. Yes.
So Margen Tembu's skill is very easy. It's like two lines of text. Like, I can read it really simply. Just count last one, choose one card for your G-Zone and turn it face up. Choose one of your opponent's rear guards, dominate it, and then have it attack someone else, either your opponent's vanguard or your another rear guard. At the end of the battle of all this, the person that you have dominated by Margen Tembu is retired. And it's retired immediately. So that basically means you can turn Margen Tembu into a control tool to have one of your rear guards turn his back on another one of his friends. If the attack is successful, he dies, and the attacker also dies. So that means he's straight up -2. It's basically a pocket Ghandeva. To make it even worse, you can also use this to extend your attacks. For counterblast 1, you can now have another swing at the Vanguard, not counting the Oboro swing that you got from your, you know, your Shrike skill. So, in basics, Margen Tembu was one of the cards that people said, oh, this deck is crap. If you've seen the rest of this deck, or if you're going to speed up and watch the rest of this deck profile, you'll realize that's absolutely not the case. But this is the basic premise of what Shirani does. All the domination comes from the center column. A bit more further up in the ladder, this is at that moment before, you know, Shirani goes under house arrest, for those of you who read the law. This is Shirani Mukuro. At his moment of being trapped on Earth, he decides, hey, you know what, these kids need to be fucked. So Shirani Mukuro, you Soul Blast 1. There's no G Persona Flip and it's GB2. You can only access Shirani Mukuro by Ultimate Striding, or, you know, for as the kids say, Persona Striding. By doing so, you straight up get to choose your opponent's rear guards and dominate it. Exactly the same, right? It attacks your opponent's Vanguard or anyone else, right?
You can only attack the Vanguard.
This one's only the Vanguard. So, Margen Tembu is anyone. Shiranui, he forces the opponent's rear guard to attack their Vanguard. And then afterwards, immediately after the battle ends, he dominates you instead and then gets you to attack someone else. You don't have to attack the guy that attacked back.
Correct.
But it also can be. Because yes, technically, as the skill is separated by a full stop, I thank the judges, that's clarified. What happens is, once that battle ends, the guy you just dominated is no longer counted as a dominated unit. Now you are the one that's dominated. So you now start the attack on one of your own friends. So Shiranui is the essence of the schoolgirl, turning everyone else against each other and watching them all die. But if you want to see your locals die as well, let's go to the main deck.
Oh yeah, just so you know, since you're dominating your opponent's Vanguard, you'll get an additional twin drive.
I mean, that's assuming they're on great tree.
And if you hit the over trigger, you get to resend the dominated unit and attack with it again.
And one more thing, because he's dominated the Vanguard, you can't guard the attack. You can't guard the attack because you don't have a Vanguard to count it. I realize that. Thank you. That's something very important that most people don't remember from G era, or they've removed the premium from their knowledge because, you know, premium's irritating. The thing is that, yeah, you dead ass can't guard his attack. So no matter what he chooses to use you to attack, you don't get a say. That's really sad. I wish there was something we could do, right? I wish life could be better. Moving on to our great trees for the deck, we play 3 copies of Shiranui in the main deck. We play 4 copies of this guy, and then 1 copy of Shiranui for the right
deck. In the right deck. Alright, so 3 copies of Shiranui in the main deck, very simple. You are adept, is your access to Shiranui Oboro. It is your strongest stride. You want to go into it as much as you can. Because it's an additional 2 swings for free and more cards in your hand due to Twin Drive. You need as many dominate attacks as possible, because it will trigger certain effects later on, which is why you want to go into Oboro as much as possible. Otherwise, you are okay. The other grade 3 we are playing, it's our Strife Order from DBT13. Its first effect is, if your Vanguard, when placed on Rearguard Circle, you can either, if your Vanguard is a grade 4, or you can reveal a grade 4 from your hand.
Which you cannot unless you are playing Esper Idea. But you're not doing that anymore.
Not in this deck. No,
this is from Triple Drive Booster. So if all of you are whining that you can't afford it, buy it.
It's reprinted. It's cheaper now.
Cheaper now.
But yes, I mean, if you're playing Esper Idea, you can reveal the Esper Idea. But if you're not, the only time you can use the on-play skill is when you have Shiranui itself. So the skill itself is you get to choose one of your opponent's rear guard and retire it, and it gains plus 5k. Very simple, it's a minus 1, but mainly we are playing it for its second ability is when you are going to ride into a grade 3 or you are paying for cost for stride, if you discarded this card, you get to draw one card. So why are we playing this instead of base Shiranui? Well, that's because of the additional possibility of the draw when you are riding up to Shiranui Oboro.
So it stops you from grade 2 gaming, it gives you incentive to ride up.
Yes. So it gives you more draws, and overall it's it's a free retire, and this deck has control, but if your opponent really wants to flood the board and they have way too many important pieces that you want to get rid of, sometimes you just want to place this down and retire the rear guard. It doesn't matter where you place it, just retire something.
Yeah, we are gonna have to move a bit faster because this deck still has much more to go. But moving on to our grade twos, we play 4 copies of our good friend Fulai, 1 copy of Gengai, 4 copies of, who the hell are you?
Zankei,
okay, yeah, that's
all right. So, Gengai is part of your right deck. So,
yeah,
we've already gone through that.
You could play one or two more extra, but I feel at this point you have too many good cards. So.
Yes. So, the deck is a bit
idea.
Too long. So, sure, Gengai is a good card, but it's not really
not worth that slot, right?
Yes, I'm using it for another card that you'll see it later.
Yes.
So, we'll go through Furai's effect first, because this is the one you want to see on first try. So, Furai's effect. Continuous, for every battle taken place this turn by a dominated unit, this unit gets plus 5k. So, that's why I say Shiranui Oboro gives an additional dominate attack, which gives Furai an additional 5k. So this can matter. Its other effect is GB1, so you have to have Shiranui first. If your dominated unit attack this turn, when your Vanguard attacks, you can Soul Blast 1 and stand this unit. Congratulations, we have a grade 2 Esper idea.
Woo! It's not once per turn.
Neither is Esper idea.
Esper idea is once per turn.
It is?
You should check the cards you buy from your reprint set.
Man, it's a good thing.
Seike is also not once per turn.
Yes.
Right? But it's tied between, you know, the Vanguard deck. So you need to check a job for that. Yeah. But realistically, if you do, you just win and Shihai the entire way to the top.
Okay, anyway, moving on to Zankei. Zankei's effect is Furai's second effect, but a bit better.
A bit.
If your dominated unit attack this turn, when your Vanguard attacks, you can Soul Blast 1 to stand this unit. If your Gzone has 2 or more face-up cards, this unit gets plus 10k and you get to draw 1.
Amazing Shiranui pluses! But something you should be knowing here is that compared to Furai, it is better in the late game. But the other thing to note is that it's also 2 cards face-up in the Generation Zone, which is either GB2 if you don't stride or GB3 if you did stride. So that means you kind of have to use Margan Tambu's effect fully, then
the following stride
turn, any following strike turn, you get to use I'm very biased towards the new cards. This is Seikei. The other guy is Zankei. New recruits, we always get the name wrong. But the other thing also that means, I think this card will hint to you, you actually have one way to counterplay Shiranui, and that is to counterblast Deny. This is why we were kind of phobic, as you'll see later on playing that many counterblast cards. If your opponent is playing either straight out of the box Shiranui, or he's playing a lot more greedier and needs a lot more counterblast, you can actually stop their plan by 2 turns extra by just not dealing them damage. So keep that in mind when playing against Shiranui. Not all decks can do this though. If you're playing My Goal, you will need to keep attacking them no matter what. But the idea is there that there is an option for you to counterblast Deny for D series. Okay, I can't say this for P, I can't say this for V, because it ain't happening. Yeah, it ain't happening.
Anyway, Furai is better for power, because its power is on the first and second battle because of the continuous effect. Meanwhile, Seike, it can only gain a 10k when it restands. So if you are trying to look at your opponent's hand, sometimes Furai can be better in the late game.
Yeah.
Alright, moving on to the great ones.
That's right.
We play 4 PGs because we are playing Vanguard. 1 card in the right deck, 3 Zankeis, because it came with the Stride deck set. 3 Ronovia, and 3 copies of Katarigisune, and 2 copies of Sekire. Tenray.
I go through Tenray. Tenray is a favorite card of mine because he is the nightmare of a lot of premium judges. He gives you a lot of rulings, he gives you a lot of questions. 3/4 of your judge test, Lord Drop-Off, comes from this card alone. Valios, I love you. The thing with this card is that in this series, I think they forgot what he did. So they changed him to Hanada Halfway. So what does this guy do when placed on a regular circle? If you have the Shiranui crest, which basically means you're playing this game, count plus one, Joker.
Very simple.
What the hell? Like, bro, come on. This can't be real. When your dominated unit attacks, hits a Vanguard, or just hits in general, this guy goes back to the hand. That's it. So you get a reusable Hanada Halfway.
What? Bermuda Triangle?
What? Yeah, it's not fair. I want to sell Avangard. Avangard's a shit then, bro.
There's a reason why we're only playing two copies. Yes, you still want to play it in the deck because it's still a draw.
But we'll get Kalblast denied, so we have to be careful.
So, yeah.
Then, we play 4 PGs because we want to stay alive. This is a stealth PG, so for all my Megalazuchi fans, you will need to buy this. It is from your
Shiranui Strike deck set.
And your boss is from Triple Drive Booster, so buy your boxes. Isazoi, I love you. Yeah, he gets searched by Isazoi. This is Seizui is from the right deck. I've gone through him before. Katakitsune is your strike fodder. During your main phase, you can just ditch him, search your deck for a copy of Mani Shiranui Oboro from the main deck or from the drop zone. So I've gone through the Jet deck profile very recently. It is the same as Deep Breath. So yeah, really, you start to see a lot of similarities here. We're only playing 3 because we have so much strike fodder in the deck.
And if need be, it itself is a strike fodder. So you can use it as well.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
You want to go through which one first?
This one.
Alright, go ahead.
Alright, so Zanke, it has 2 effects. So the first effect on Rega Circle, for every dominated attack that hit this turn, this unit gets plus 5k. So the more attacks that hit by your dominated units, the more power this guy gets, which is very good. Its other effect is, once per turn, GB1, when your units attack hit, which includes your dominated units, you get 2, so charge 1, but this is a once per turn. But it's not and once per copy. The more guys you have him...
it's a soft once per turn, basically.
Yes. So, this is very important because, as you saw just now, all of the re-standers require a Soul Blast to re-stand. Your Vanguard Shiranui Mukuro also requires a Soul Blast. This is a very soul-heavy deck, so you want to see Zanke as soon as you can so that you can place him during your first strike turn so you can start generating resources as early as possible. And finally, we have my tech card, Ranovate. So, what is she is...
Where's she from?
She is from DBT-13, actually.
So she's very new.
Yes, she is very new. She is a double rare from that set. So her effect is continuous back row center rearguard circle. It doesn't happen anywhere else. It has to be your back row center rearguard circle. Any unit that was placed by your Vanguard's effect this turn gets plus 5k. Congratulations, this is why we are playing Genkai. So Genkai itself, when rolled upon, you get to call itself out of soul. This itself is a Vanguard effect. So it gets plus 5k. Then a part of the same effect is to call a unit from your opponent's drop zone. And whatever you call out of the drop zone also gets plus 5k. This helps a lot in hitting bigger numbers.
It checks over so much magic numbers in early game, it's insane. It really feels like Fate Riders 1 to 5 pushback here.
Yes, so this is our budget option compared to Shenri, because guess what? Shenri is a $60 card, and not many people can afford it.
No, it's 7,000 yen already.
Inflation, right?
Yeah, but inflation. If you want to be realistic, it's not just about being cheap or expensive. This is a card that has great synergy with this deck, and as I'll explain in the conclusion, the reason why we built the deck the way it does is to counterplay a lot of the strategies we have seen at WGP.
Yes. Shiranui is a very well-known deck at this point, so it is very important for us to be able to adapt to whatever our opponents are predicting. So finally, for the trigger lineup, we are running 8 fronts, 3 crits, 4 heals, and 1 over trigger. Front triggers, they are an amazing tool in the game. You cannot stress how much front triggers will save you. Alright, they can save your rear guards during your opponent's turn. So if you hit a front trigger during your opponent's turn, it will give your entire front row power. If you hit it during your own turn, you are now asking for 2 more cards at least from the effect of giving your entire front row plus 10k. And since you're already hitting like a truck, due to the crest, this just makes the deck a lot more threatening compared to critical triggers,
which only allow you to boost one attacker.
Yes.
And in addition, it saves your wallet because this has also been reprinted in
Triple Drive Booster!
Buy your boxes, children.
Also, the extra shield is nice from the effect front.
Yeah, it's nice. The other shield, the other front is just a normal front. Doesn't matter where you get it from.
You get it in the Stride Deckset. So if you buy the Stride Deckset,
I mean, you are buying the Stride Deckset. That's why it's here.
Yes.
Yeah. We play 3 crits. We would like to play 4 crits, but realistically, we also need for the over trigger.
Yes.
So you can balance between 7 fronts and 8 fronts. It's fine, but to us, we generally enjoy the front pressure. It helps us get the damage more, and it also allows us to have larger attacks over time.
If you really think you are suffering for soul, feel free to play the effect crits. But for me, I like having the 5k base because it makes magic numbers sometimes.
And it's stealth, so it's on team. And then we have play 4 heals. Any heals counts, frankly, doesn't matter.
Yes.
Okay, now we are going to go on to my favorite part of this video. Of every Stride Deck set that I review, is the conclusions. Shiranui is no stranger to all of you by now. The fact that I've taken a whole month to delay this video, you all should have seen this already live and in the flesh. So why am I doing this video a few days before ban list? First of all, I wanted to show a much more different form of Shiranui. I wanted to show a list that you don't see often using methods that is not really popular per se. Stuff like, for example, you know,
Ghandeva.
It's not that popular, but it can be. So it's something worth looking at. Two, I also wanted to mention the counters to Shiranui. Counters to Shiranui, like I said, you can CB deny a lot of their plays, especially if they're more greedy. You can also just not call any rear guards going in this particular turn, so that when they eventually ride up from Shoujo Doji back to Shiranui, they actually have no way to dominate the board, which means they lose the game. And of course, last but not least, you also have this. So realistically speaking, there are multiple ways you can stop Shiranui, as long as you've not only done your research, but you're able to read the scenario fairly. With that being said, is Shiranui the meta warping threat that he has been told to us as? Unironically a bit, yes. Because this is a deck that comes straight out of a 6,000 yen product. You can't deny that this thing is not accessible. This thing is everywhere. Everyone will play this. Everyone will try it. From the people who loved it back in G, the people who picked it up in V, and the people that want to win in D, everyone will try this deck set. So instead of whining on Twitter and saying, I hate this deck, instead of going around saying, I want the deck set banned, no. Let's be mature about this. Let's learn its counters. Learn how you can stop it. Learn how to play it as well. I mean, it's pretty interesting if you enjoy winning. But if not, there's really a lot of things that you can learn from this deck. This video has been filmed before the Divine's announcement. So maybe by the time we reach the Divine's, you know, the product announcement, we may just get a whole new defensive mechanic to stop Shiranui. We may get a ban list for Shiranui. I don't know at this point. I think it's too early to hit anything. I think we can all agree on that. But I think that the main point we need to take away is that, you know, every format has a meta, right? But it determines on how you adapt to that meta. Except premium, because there's nothing you can do against Medistar. Thank you all so much for watching. I'll see you all next time. Goodbye.
And hey, for my Shiranui players out there, Divines will bring more cards. Just wait. Alright? It can be a bit cold sometimes, I know. But just hold out. Shiranui will never betray you.
So when we eventually get the... Oh god. Oh god.